Hello everyone and welcome to another Legacy video. Today I'm recording with a very weird deck. A deck that I called like Four Color Guided Passage. A similar deck like this, 5 of the League. It's based on this card that says 3 mana, you give your opponent your deck, and they pick from it a creature, a land, and non creature slash non-land. So they give you 3 cards in your hand. And so basically it's like a draw spell that only draws a spell, a draw card that, you know, can't it land. Your opponent is gonna probably give you like Deathrite Shaman, Bolt, and giving you a land or and a land, which I mean, it's kind of sweet, you know, getting this card advantage. Like, you could play this deck with like Ancestral Vision, but I guess this one's sweeter. The rest of the deck is a 4-color card advantage deck. We play Force of Will because why not? We play Bloodbraid Elf. We're not playing Shardless Agent because in the 3-drop slot, there's a True Name and Leovolds, you know, to fill in that curve. That's why I guess Shardless Agent is not being played anymore because the 3-drop just evolved a lot into like the Leovold Nemesis slot. Then we have Abricay, you know, to keep destroying counterbalance. No, it's a joke. Counterbalance is no longer around. So it's just there because, you know, it's just a good card. And Baleful Strix, because again, it's a pretty good card against Delver decks and etc. Tarmogoyf is just great. Shaman, Bolt, Ponder, and Brainstorm. You know, pretty straightforward deck list once you pass this 3-drop mana curve, which was a little unfamiliar with. 21 lands, no wasteland, only dual lands to be able to fix our 4-color mana base very well. In the sideboard we got something against Storm. 3 Flusterstorm, since we're gonna board out Bloodbraid in that matchup. Arcane Lab says each player can't cast more than one spell per turn. So this is good even against Show and Tell, since you they can play Show and Tell, you can play this and ideally just attack for lethal. But most likely your opponent is gonna put Omnitail and then you're gonna die the turn after. But you know, if everything goes according to the plan, you can still do something against them with Arcane Lab. Surgical Extraction against Reanimator or everything else, you know, Punishing Fire, whatever. Life from the Loam. Engineer Plague, I think that this deck is on the slow side, so I like Engineer Plague since it's good against like elves, goblins, and whatever, humans, merfolks, slivers, and etc. etc. Ancient Grudge, I like it against the Stoneforge Mystic. In a deck like this, I really can't afford to play Ancient Grudge. I really love it because it basically destroys. It's like a Surgical Extraction for Mystic, but proactive. So your opponent pays mana to cast, every artifact, and then you destroy them with just one card. Umezawa Jite, I feel it's very good with a True Name. I might even play the main deck, but I don't know, you know, what to cast. So here we are, and then 3 Gravedigger's Cage against, elves, against everything. Okay, a graveyard mostly. All right, let's head to a league. First round on the play, and this is obviously a good hand. Let's keep in mind our mana base, which is some Underground Sea and Taiga to get all the colors we need, or Tropical Badland, or Volcanic Bayou. Alright, those are the combinations. But here we're just gonna go plain and simple with Underground Sea Deathrite Shaman. I say that this every time, but if you have an end like this with Mistyrian Forest and Underground Sea, you should lead with Underground Sea, because your opponent might do a bad decision and not fetch. Let's say they have like a fetch land or a regular land to play their 2 spells. They want to play the regular land so that they don't give us a fetch land, because they don't know we have a fetch land yet. That's a little things to know, but if you're new to the format, you can do a mistake there. Okay, opponents go Gitaxian Prep, say they are gonna know all of our secrets. And
Our opponent just went Tropical Island, go. I'm gonna play a Fetchland first, because I don't want to get dazed or whatever, since this Brainstorm is pretty important. I want to shuffle away those two lands, if I can. Opponent doesn't know we drew Ponder, which is obviously pretty good here. Alright. I think we can discard it. There's actually this two Fetchlands. Being in Mana Screw with two Deathrite Shaman, it's not a big of a deal, and finding lands is not that hard. So I'm gonna get Trop here. Ooh, Stifle. Alright. I guess I still have those two Fetchlands on top, so I'm just gonna... I think I'm gonna play just Deathrite Shaman here. It's so good against decks that tries to stifle your wasteland. Your fetchlands. Every deck with stifle, just being on the play, you know, have the Deathrite Shaman draws, you're so behind. Because your main plan is to mana deny your opponent, but your opponent is just, you know, without even... This is not a huge cost for us. We just put Deathrite Shaman in our deck, and they happen to be great against every deck with Stifle and Wasteland. That's why that strategy, I really dislike the Stifle Wasteland strategy. Because there's just those decks that naturally... Yeah. Alright, so we have a land on top and then another land. And so we're gonna draw that land and probably just play Tarmogoyf and maybe attack for two. I also can just draw the other land. Also, here my opponent, I mean, doesn't know my whole land. Like, my whole land, he just knows zero cards, because the probe saw... Because the three cards we just drew all fresh off the Brainstorm. Alright, after like 3 minutes of Brainstorm, my opponent finally resolved it and played Mystery Forest and passed. So we draw that land. And I think I'm trying to fetch land and play Tarmogoyf here. See if our opponent goes to strip my to stifle again. And I will come accept it. Yeah. Alright, sure. I'm gonna just play Tarmogoyf and attack for one here. We have another land on top of the deck waiting for us. And board presence, very, very, very good, let's say. So here, just attack it. Don't even bother to cast Ponder. This land in the graveyard, it's pretty important. And we're basically not looking for anything. We're not looking for a Force of Will. Like, we're not against a combo deck. So Force of Will is not... like. Maybe our opponent here can play True Name Nemesis. That would be annoying. But other than that, not really into looking for anything. And... also, you don't really want to take away the land in the graveyard, since it's kind of important. And yeah, I didn't even know there was foil stifle. It's kind of weird. And yeah, so let's see if they have true name, which here would be pretty good. Against True Name here, I mean, it's gonna be a pretty hard time dealing with True Name. How do you deal with that? You just don't. I mean, yeah. Just play your own True Name. Alright, Deathrite, sure. We can bolt that. It's so weird, because my opponent even knew that we had all those lands, alright? So, yeah. Alright, let's just take Badland, I guess. And bolt this Deathrite. So this is gonna be a 4/5 now, and I'm gonna attack with, I think, both creatures. Opponent's probably gonna... I already came at Tarmogoyf, and that'll be fine by me. Okay. This looks like a 4-color Delver from my opponent's side. He doesn't know that we have, like, Blob Raid Elf and Guided Passage in the deck. Well, future guided passage here would have been very sweet. Gurmagankler. That'll be a problem. Sure, maybe I should have used my death rate. No, I had Arbor Decay up, so it's okay. Opponent goes to 11, which are yet another land. I think I'm fine enjoying Ponder and shuffling the rest. So that I can, yeah. I left three more look at the top card. I'm gonna get Tropical Island here. Lightning Bolt. Yeah, I guess I'll take those cards. I like to have Lightning Bolt in my hand with two death rate open. I could just bolt my opponent and then, you know, the usual death rate dance. I'll just deal four, bolt, deal four. The opponent doesn't do anything and just attack. I go to 11 and then probably I'm gonna bolt his face. It's gonna go down to 8, then down to 6 with the death rate activation. And yeah. And then to 2, yeah. I like that. Death rate is so good. Or how did my opponent do? He shuffled. Probably looking for an answer for the death rate. Please use all death, but I think I'm gonna answer the death rate with Arbor Decay and not with Bolt. I just wanna bolt his face. Alright, two cards in his hand. I'm gonna bolt him and then deal him two. I do in this order, of course, because I can play around days this way. Alright, so it's at 6. I drop Ponder, which I'm probably not that interested in casting. Just gonna destroy this and attack, I think. Yeah, I'm not that interested in casting Ponder here. Opponent is gonna be dead next turn if he doesn't find an answer for death rate, and I don't have any one card that deals with their answer. There's no like Thoughtseize or whatever in the deck. Yeah, I just get my damage, and yeah, so my opponent can't really fetch here. I mean, they can't like fetch and removal because they would die no matter what. Now my opponent goes to 3 and yeah. Alright. Just gonna deal him 2. Now he has to answer the death rate. If they have an answer. Looks like they don't, so yeah, I'm just gonna bolt. Just gonna bolt him twice and that's gonna be game. There's no life gain card in Legacy, other than Source Flushers, basically. Alright, so, and here to Mizawa. Alright, so we are against Sultai Delver at Call. The Stifle, it's a clear Delver signal. So I'm gonna board in Umezawa Jite, and I don't know, that's probably gonna be it. That's probably gonna be it. The setboard is designed for other decks here. I don't know if you want Engineer Plague for like opponent true name, though it looks very weird because we have our own true name. We might have Flusterstorm, but I don't really think I want it. The opponent has Stifle. Yeah, I might want the Flusterstorm. I'm gonna just board out two. Blob Braid might be too expensive against a deck with Wasteland and Stifle. I'm gonna just have two and yeah, it'll be fine. Let's go with this. This looks like another deck. Don't have one drops, so we just have, you know, mid-rangey creatures. That might be bad against Stifle and Wasteland. Alright, they have their own death threat. I don't want to force off with this, even though it's great because of these. Now I can, I think I gonna fetch main phase one. Maybe not. I mean, fetch main phase one means I can play around Stifle, but not Wasteland. Probably I'm just gonna play Misty and pass. Yeah, I'm playing around Wasteland here. Because, I don't know. I don't even know why. Or should I just play the fetch, dual land? Right, I have a Candy Cannon as well in their deck. So it's a four-color Delver. We can force fill this. It's gonna be pretty annoying. I think I'm going to force this with Leovold. Opponent can daze and stifle, that would be pretty bad, but at least they got rid of two cards in their hand. Did not trigger a Young Pyromancer, only a force back. Pitch Brainstorm. I'm gonna fetch now, so if my opponent has stifle, they can't. They are not going to make the token. Alright. Impermanence resolves. And I mean, that was pretty bad because I gave my opponent a land in the graveyard, though. The thing with the stifle, I think it's pretty important. Let's just jam a Tarmogoyf here. My opponent can bolt it. That would be pretty bad, though. I want to curve out. I have 2-3 drops, and there might not be time to cast Tarmogoyf anymore, so. Yeah, looks like they have a bolt, and the two cards they have in their hand. I mean, you're not happy to trade a bolt with Tarmogoyf with a bolt and the token, obviously, it's pretty bad. Though, I think having this good 3 drop in my hand, I just wanted to curve out. I'm going to probably cast Leovold here. Maybe True Name is better because my opponent can't kill it. Yeah. Leovold is better against Wasteland, and True Name is better against like Bolt or Decay, which my opponent plays. Alright, True Name, very happy resolved, since now there are not that many answers. Like, what's the name? 2 mana black. -1/-1 to your opponent card. It would be a pretty bad thing. Marsh Quasitis would be pretty bad here. But other than that, my opponent can't really pass through this. And then we can go Blob Raid. I guess instead I will go Leovold and Bolt. I think Bolt is more important than Leovold. I'm gonna Bolt now, so then my opponent is tapped out. I go down to 10 with a Fetchland. Okay. I'm gonna grab what? Probably a Badland. Oh, they have Stifle. Okay. Then I'm happy that I played Bolt first, since I'm more interested in having the death rate died than the Leovold in play. Was not obviously not money efficient at all, but it's priorities. Death rate represented 2 more damage and 1 more mana. I had my opponent's choice. My Leovold, yeah, sure, my opponent can now brainstorm or ponder, but I think my life is a resource in this game. I'm just gonna die from like some random damage, not from board presence, since my hand it's so good later in the game. Opponent got the green mana and now can cast what? Tarmogoyf would be good. I mean, if I had Golgari Charm, he can't really have Golgari Charm here. Looks like he tapped that way, but I never see play Young Pyromancer and Golgari Charm in the same deck. Alright. No, I think I'm gonna play Leovold here. My opponent is obviously bad against Daze, but my opponent didn't have it like 2 turns ago. And Death Rate, if my opponent just has a Bolt, it's again a bad mana efficiency. Okay, opponent drew Jace, that's fine. They had only two cards, so I think, and didn't have it last turn, two turns ago, so when I cast True Name, so they had to draw it in two turns, which, I mean, it's totally fine. I think it was more likely an opponent had like Abu Decay or Lightning Bolt than Jace. That's why I played that way. Okay, Wasteland, it's a little annoying, but they have Death Threat to provide me some mana. Okay, opponent's trading one elemental for two damage, which is totally reasonable, considering that, you know, that's what Pyromancer does. Opponent has one land in his hand, like Volcanic Island in his hand. Let's keep that in mind. Yeah, this is not the best moment to draw this card. Maybe the next turn. Okay, maybe they should have Abu Decay in their hand, I think, from how they played. Yeah, because they tapped green and black mana, but I didn't realize that True Name can't be killed. Yeah, but I mean, they couldn't have done anything different. No opponent has Volcanic Island, is gonna put me on 6. If I draw a red source here, it's insane. If I draw the Aether Shaman, it's insane. Opponent has one card in his hand. I draw Force of Will, which it's not the worst. Don't really understand Blobbird Elf in this deck though. You could just play more 3 drop or like even Shardless Agent. It's gonna be good. Opponent's trading one elemental for one damage. That I don't like. I like trading one elemental for two damage, that's fine, but one for one, it's not good. See if they draw anything good there. Death Threat, oh no, I can't let Death Threat resolve. Yeah. I got onto 4 here. Opponent with one unknown card. We just have Blobbery, which is kind of a blank. Oh, Flasus is good. Yeah, I'm super dead here, I think. I have to draw removal spell for Death Threat, like an Abu Decay right away. Can't even draw Bolt, just Abu Decay. And then I'm still gonna be pretty far behind. Yeah, dead. I mean, I was kind of behind the old game. I think I'll like leave the deck as it is. I like Forces. I don't love Blobbird, I think 2 are enough. Don't love Last of Storm. Yeah, let's just go with this. Alright, on the play against Sultai Delver. That's not 4 color though. Yes. Deathrite Shaman. Decks like this with Deathrite Shaman just, you know, became something else. I'm gonna go for the classic Underground Sea, I think. Just classic turn 1 in Legacy, Underground Sea, Deathrite Shaman. And let's see if our opponent present the same curve. Oh, probe, sure. Yeah, one opponent probed me. I should have instantly thought about Young Pyromancer though, because decks like this, like Sultai Delver never plays Probe. But I guess he's kind of a weird list with Stifle in it. So maybe he brewed that, but whatever. Underground Sea and what does he play? Death Threat, sure. I'm gonna go Brainstorm and then Abdicate the Death Threat most likely. Alright, what do we shuffle away? Can shuffle away the Forces here. It's kind of a land heavy though. We shuffle away one land and a Force, yeah. Just get Trop and destroy the Death Threat. Still have Force of Will active though. We're ready to shuffle that away with the next brainstorm. Maybe our opponent is gonna decay our death row, maybe bolt it. Who knows? Sure. Alright. And these own death ray. Okay, I can't daze, obviously, because I can't force them. I mean, ooh, guided passage. Alright, let's play. I mean, I can also play just guided passage. If I put in daze, I force. That's still card advantage because it's three cards for two. Like, I use three cards, he uses two, he uses one, and I get again three cards. So, I guess I can do that. But it's also good just going for the brainstorm and looking for like lightning bolt. Or even Abra Cave would be somewhat fine here. Leo Bolt. What do I shuffle? I think I like all the lands here. I might just shuffle away for some brainstorm. That's kind of weird though. I think I like that. I mean, you know what I'll do, I just put Force second and brainstorm top, and then I play Polluted Delta, and then if, you know, I don't need to answer anything, I'm gonna draw the brainstorm. If I do need to answer something, I'm gonna just shuffle away. Also, maybe what, my opponent has Typhon in their deck, so maybe I just want to to fetch now. I kind of wanted the Taiga because I want the other land on, because I'm going to wasteland me. So I think I'm just going to shuffle those. Yeah, Brainstorm is kind of bad to shuffle away, but I think I'm kind of like everything at this point. So I'm just going to get... So Taiga makes up for green. Maybe I just get bad land and then my opponent can't really wasteland me of any color. Because if they wasteland, yeah, bad land is the best here. Just gonna play this and pass the turn. Yeah, it's kind of weird that I could have played Guided Passage, that would be probably very good. Now my opponent has 4 mana to work with. Let's see what they can do. Deathrite. If my Deathrite survive, they're gonna stare each other. But the opponent is gonna probably looking for some answers for it. Though, looking at the deck, what can my opponent give me with the Guided Passage? Maybe Blob Raid. And then Ritual Baleful Strix. It's pretty good in this matchup. Opponent did not shuffle. Okay. Delver of Secrets and... Yeah, looks like they're using the death threat. You know, if you have like a combination like this, you have to, and you can't Abra Decay, you have to, before add the man. Oh no, splitting another Delver. Okay, so my death threat is surviving. Interesting. 2 cards left. Delvers are going to flip. And they don't have an answer. I can't get it with Guided Passage. But it's gonna probably give me like a Ponder or a Brainstorm. Kinda happy how I played this. I have another Ponder. So what do I do? I think I'm just gonna jam Guided Passage here. Yeah. Let's jam it. Yeah. Definitely jamming Guided Passage here. Opponent can't Flusterstorm Storm it. And, yeah. Alright, got a passage irresolving. Let's see what my opponent gives me. She's gonna give me a land, a creature land, sorry, a creature card, and a non-creature non-land card. Is this a 3-for-1? And, it's gonna probably just give me, okay, looking for, looking, death threat is gonna give me, that's interesting, okay. And then, I mean, I already played the land, so I can't actually gain that land. And maybe force of is gonna give me. It's gonna be the card my opponent gives me. No ponder. Okay, I think I'm gonna just go death rate and ponder. Maybe ponder and death rate. Though that will be plain under days, so I think I'm gonna just death rate first and then ponder. Yeah, I like this better. Opponent will flip the Delver since he played ponder. Or I like these cards. Okay, and then I pass. So a Baleful Strix is gonna look probably resolve one of the Delver. This isn't gonna go like Leovold Baleful Strix. Resolving with Brainstorm, okay. Got on to 11. Now I gotta do some death threat dance here. Let's see if my opponent proceed with the board here or just answer mine. Looking for maybe, yeah, it's dealing me two. It's dealing me two damage. It's okay. Oh, another death threat. Okay. Yeah, sure. I'm gonna play Leovold first and then Baleful Strix. Green, black, blue. And the Baleful to draw me that. Okay, but this is force of will in this. Maybe Red Elemental Blast. Or Brainstorm. Oh, yeah, sure, of course, you put Brainstorm here. It's pretty bad Brainstorm since my opponent has to draw the card that it put on top with Brainstorm, though obviously you can't let Leovold resolve with Brainstorm in your hand. Now I drew pretty bad Underground Sea, but yeah. Opponent doesn't have double black for death threat yet. I mean, it's gonna probably draw it. There's a lot of new cards. Here I chose obviously not to gain two life with death threat since if my opponent has like anything, he just kills me with the two death threat activation. Whereas now the opponent wants to use the death threat. It's gonna be only two damage. But I'm gonna get one tap with my untap death threat that can gain me four life. Alright, then they don't click. Sure, I'm not really interested in, you know, my cards are all medium. So I'm going to target in me. Okay, so gonna draw a card. There's not really much here. Like maybe you get the ponder. Because I have to look for some answers for those flyers. And this part is literally, it's pretty intense. Yeah, you got rid of the true name. Got rid of Fan. But sure, okay, so now my opponent can't deal me 2 damage. Because if he's gonna exile a card with death threat, I'm gonna exile it back, so. He's gonna just attack for 3 because he blocked one of those and pass. Actually, no, that's wrong. My opponent exile a card. He's going to succeed dealing me 2 damage because he can exile a black an instant. I'm gonna exile a land back, and it's gonna exile the land. It's gonna exile the land. So, yeah, he's going to do it. Sure, I mean, I have to try since it's basically free. So I go down to 4. Yeah, I'm gonna just exile my land. I mean, the land in response so that it doesn't gain the mana. Alright. So I'm down to 4 here. Drew another true name. It's not really what I wanted to draw. Let's see with this ponder what I can get. Whoa.
Whoa.
Those are very good cards here. So. I wish this was a brainstorm instead of a ponder though. Let's see. So if we go land and you cheat to keep, I can kill the Vendilion click. But it's gonna probably block though, the Leovold. If I go Baleful Strix here, what's happening? Do I die? I think I don't die. It's pretty interesting. I can go Baleful Strix and draw the Fluster Storm with Baleful Strix. Then I can play Baleful Strix and what else? Put the Baleful Strix and leave 3 mana on top for the death rate. Instead, if I go Mesaeus Ishita keep on the Leovold, my opponent, if he wants to block, I can kill the Insect Liberation and then I'm gonna have a huge edge on the board. Do I though? I'm going to... I will have an Underground Sea untapped, so my opponent... And 2 death rates on top. So my opponent can't really gain. Or, alternatively, I can keep Jite on the death threat and attack. My opponent's gonna take, and then I'm gonna kill the Vendilion click. And I will have 1 mana left for the death threat. So my opponent's gonna deal me only 2 damage. No, that's not gonna be good. I think I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna just take the Baleful Strix. And shuffle the Reveille. Yeah, maybe I should have taken the Jite. I don't know. Either way, we're still in a... I think we are in a good spot. Yeah, maybe Jite would have... I just like having Leovold out. Just like having Leovold out. Gonna do like this. Yeah, maybe I'm supposed to. I was supposed to play the Jite. I think I want to attack here. I like the trade. And, yeah. Alright, I'm gonna trade with the Delver. And I'm gonna go down to 1. Let's see what my opponent does. He's just passing. And obviously I don't touch anything here. Because if I gain 2, what's happening? If I gain 2 with a death threat, my opponent will... deal me 2. Yeah, no, that's bad. Yeah, so it's just on top. And let's play this Mesaeus Jite. Which could have been played last turn. Yeah. Was pretty rough. I don't know how I should have played this. Now if my opponent has Abdicated Eye. Which last turn it was tapped out, so... Yeah, should have probably done that. Now also I die to Lightning Bolt, but I mean... Last turn if my opponent didn't block, then I could have killed this. Yeah, I don't know, maybe I didn't think about every options I had. Okay, can't decay this, but he can definitely bolt this. Because I have this polluted data that I can't fetch. He can bolt me and I can't force back, so... That looks like my opponent wanted me to tap it out for Flaster Storm, though. I still die. Yeah, maybe here I still die. Even if I... get this Leovold. If they get this cheetah. Even if I get this cheetah counter, we are still die. Yep. I put myself dead on board, I think, but there was not really much I could have done, I think. Maybe if I had attacked with the cheetah last turn, that would have been different. Yeah, here I'm dead. I don't know, that was a tough match. So last turn, instead of having the Baleful Strix, I go Jita. And my opponent doesn't block, obviously. And then what do I do with this Jita counter? I was at 4. I could have killed the Vandalion Click and take the 3 damage from the Delver. I go down to 1, then again 2, I go to 3, but he had those death, right? I don't know. Tough match, tough match. Alright, I hope you enjoyed still. Good game. Let's be back for the second round.